Arizona is brought to you by the UPS Store, We Know Logistics, and by Vequiva. New members get up to $20 in free bonus play with a Players Club card at Vequiva Casino.
Mark McClune in for Todd Walsh tonight. The Coyotes turn the page to the month of March tonight on Fox Sports Arizona, welcoming the Columbus Blue Jackets to town. And oh, what a month of February it was for the Phoenix Coyotes, goaltending-wise, starting with Mike Smith, the NHL first star. Look at the record, look at the save percentage. But goaltending is in good hands for the franchise for many years to come with Mike Smith playing the way he's playing this season, coming over from Tampa Bay. And look at Mark Byzantine, the OHL goalie of the month. Look at his record and his save percentage. Both goalies killing it in the month of February, and the Coyotes trying to get off to a good start tonight in Glendale in the month of March here on Fox Sports Arizona.
All right, thanks a lot, Mark, and welcome to the show, by the way. Great to have you here tonight, filling in for Todd Walsh as we get set for the Coyotes and the Columbus Blue Jackets. Time to take a look at the Chase starting goaltenders for the Coyotes. Mike Smith going for victory number 30 here tonight, a goals against average of 2.25 and a saves percentage of 927. Steve Mason down at the other end for the Columbus Blue Jackets, a rough season at 922-3 with a goals against average of 3.38 and a saves percentage at 889, but he is coming off a shutout in Denver. Gord Dwyer and Steve Kozari are the referees, and the linesman Brian Murphy and Jay Scherz, and we get a quick whistle right off the faceoff just 4 seconds into it. Two of the next three against the Columbus Blue Jackets. Tyson Nash, you got to start taking care of business against those teams lower than you in the standings.
Yes, you do. That is the biggest thing here for the Phoenix Coyotes, but this is a trap game. You cannot afford to take the Columbus Blue Jackets lightly. They will work hard. You need to match that work ethic, and it will take care of itself.
I mentioned their shutout two nights ago in Denver. They gave the Coyotes a lot to cheer about in that game because obviously Colorado is one of those teams vying for a playoff spot in the Western Conference, and a chance here to really pay it off tonight with a win over the Blue Jackets. And now back in the line it goes, and Adrian Acoin will give it to Korpikoski. Korpikoski out there right now with the former Blue Jacket Antoine Vermette and the captain Shane Doan. And this one's going to be knocked all the way back to center ice, and the Jackets will flip one in. Mark Letestu, who came over from Pittsburgh, as the Jackets go to a line change, as do the Coyotes.
Antoine Vermette starting this hockey game. This is his old club, the Columbus Blue Jackets. He'll be looking to get on the board here. Would that ever be a good feeling?
Hansel with a shot directed in front by Verbaden, steered that time by Steve Mason. That's really old-time hockey. A lot of times coaches opt to start the player who is playing against his old mates.
You know, he's got a little jump in his step. Obviously the captain too as well.
Whitney down the middle, and he got tugged a little bit at the last second there as Hansel now playing on a corner for Verbata, and his shot is on. Coyotes early in this one, buzzing around, and it's cleared all the way back for Oliver Ekman-Larsson.
I was going to say, the captain really set the tone on that first shift of the hockey game physically. He got in there on the forecheck, made a couple real big hits, sent a message to the Columbus Blue Jackets, but also to his own team. But hey, boys, follow me.
So many times, the head coach, Dave Tippett, he doesn't like to talk about the opposition. He says, we got enough to worry about ourselves, as this one is sent wide by Derek McKenzie. Played back of the line, and now it'll be sent in behind the net. McKenzie down low. Quite a success story. He's been around the league now for about 9 years. Early on, up and down. Rundblad that time lost it. Now it's played back as Derek Dorsett that time takes a run at Chris Summers. And now out of the zone it goes. And this one's going to be flipped back in as Bodker will give chase. And in behind the net is John Moore, the defenseman for Columbus. Coyotes all over it. Bodker now, and now it's Moore to take it away. And out of the zone it goes. Cleared all the way back. Chasing this one down is Aaron Johnson. Cleared away by Mike Smith, but all the way back.
Heads up play there by Smith to come out and play that puck. Adrian Acoin going backward. He was getting ready to take a big hit from the oncoming forechecker of the Columbus Blue Jackets. And that's what Mike Smith does. He makes it a real easy night for the defenseman of the Phoenix Coyotes.
Play to the line into the corner. Rafi Torres all over, but it's moved out and back to center. Darryl Boyce. Boyce came over from Toronto recently, and this one is played in where Mike Smith will give it off in behind the net. Thanks for joining us tonight on Fox Sports Arizona. Coyotes and Blue Jackets here in the opening minutes of the hockey game. Rafi Torres gets one in over the Columbus line, but it's turned the other way. And Vinny Prospo will send one in that ends up in behind the net. That's where Chris Summers will settle it down. Boy, Columbus that time backing way off, and so the Coyotes will bring it right back in over the line. And behind the net, Jack Johnson, the former King, who came over in the deal with Jeff Carter last week. Played back it over the line into the corner, Smith. And he'll steer to the corner where Chris Summers will set it up. Summers and David Rundblad. This is Rundblad's first game as a Coyote here inside Jobbing.com Arena.
His first game was against the Carolina Hurricanes, where I thought he was outstanding. His second game was against the Detroit Red Wings in Detroit, I might add. Not so good. He's getting another opportunity here against Columbus to show what he can do. Obviously, the power play struggling for the Phoenix Coyotes. Rundblad has that offensive flair. Hopefully, he can bring something to the PP here tonight.
Big hit that time by Hansel. Puck will go down the length, and Roosevelt is there to touch, and we get an icing call against Columbus. Let's jump into your keys in this one tonight, Tyson.
Well, for the Coyotes, it's always about the little things, all the little things that make you win. Blocking shots, being physical, the puck battles, and to not cheat the game. And tonight, you're playing against the Columbus Blue Jackets. You have to outwork them. The Coyotes have more skill. They have more talent. They're better on paper, but that does nothing for you unless you outwork them.
Deflected wide in front by Verbata. Ekman Larson, sharp angle, and that's steered aside. And the puck will be played all the way back. And a skate chase now as Nash will bring it in over the line. Rick Nash looked to get it to the front. And now the Coyotes will take it away. Radim Verbata back through center. Gets it in over the line. Whitney. And now it's taken away, and Derek Brassard will turn the other way for Columbus. Brassard now. Back it over the line. That's denied by Yandel and cleared out of the zone.
A good stick there by Keith Yandel. Nice tight gaps for those defensemen. They're working to get up the ice to close the gaps, not allow Columbus to have that time and space, force them to dump that puck in, and then that will allow Mike Smith to play it.
Turnover here and over the line, Pyatt. Now Pyatt gets a shot away that goes high over the top. Gillies will try to get it out. The former Minnesota Wild player is picked. Bodker now in behind the net. Back of the line, Yandel works it to Bodker. Wrister over the top. Might have been deflected in front. Hitting a piece of that was James Wisniewski. And it's dumped right back in this time by Derek Dorsett. And a shot from a sharp angle goes over the top of the net. That time from Derek McKenzie.
Nice job by that fourth line of the Phoenix Coyotes. Getting in there, getting on that puck, controlling the puck. Not only do you create momentum, you also draw a lot of penalties.
Back it over the line, Johnson has it. Shot goes wide of the mark. Summers. And now Lanco in behind the net. Flips it along for Rundblad. And now Brulé to set it up. Great to see Gilbert Brulé back out for the Coyotes.
He took a big hit in that LA Kings game against Clifford. Missed four games since then.
Brulé over the line, tried to get it to the front for Rundblad. Now behind the net, Brulé down low on the forecheck, with Dave Tippett referring to him as a rambunctious player with skill this morning at the morning skate. Robbie Torres. Now it's chipped that time past Roosevelt, but Ekman Larson back to beat Aaron Johnson to the puck. And now Doan will try to get it back in over the line, gets around Fedor Tuukka. Doan back to the front, and it's denied and turned the other way, and the Jackets will get it out. Back through center ice, Korpikoski that time all over Letestu. Puck into the corner. Now Prospo behind the net, Letestu in front, fanning out, it was Letestu, and it's turned the other way. And Doan will backhand one out, so a good look there for the Columbus Blue Jackets as we'll get an icing call here against the Coyotes.
Oh, nice job by the defense in front of Mike Smith collapsing, and Letestu just fans on this puck. What an opportunity. He'd love to have that one back. I think he was looking at where he was going to shoot it before actually shooting the puck. Look at Mike Smith as he been lights out. Didn't have his greatest game the other night, but he's looking to get back to the winning ways here tonight.
Fedor Tuukka tried to get it to the front, and it's sent over the top of the net and off netting. Jackets coming close here in the last half minute.
Coyote
Coyotes trying to get back on the winning track. Coach Tippett saying this after the Thursday loss to the Calgary Flames. He's a coach that demands perfection and saying, it's how you play. We were winning games because we were playing the right way. Mistakes are what cost you games. Of course, the Coyotes had a legendary month of February. Dave Tippett also saying this morning that you can't live in the past. You have to turn the page to the future. Coyotes trying to do it tonight, guys.
Yeah, I think so, Mark. And that is very valid in the fact that they went 11-0-1 in February. But you can't worry about or rest on your laurels of what you've done the month before. I mean, there's a huge playoff race underway. And you got to continue to maintain pace in the West, Tyson. But just 2 points ahead of the San Jose Sharks, who host of the St. Louis Blues. Now, here's the streak we're talking about. 32 goals for, 17 against. What impresses me the most are the wins over just quality opponents.
Absolutely. This team put up some big wins. San Jose, Detroit, Chicago, Vancouver. How about Dallas, Calgary in there as well? So these weren't easy games. These weren't the Columbus Blue Jackets. These were some of the best and biggest and baddest in the business.
Hansel's going to play it into the corner. He leads the team early here tonight with four hits. Back in the line, a coin for Yandle. Yandle will get one to the front, but Verbata that time can't find the deflection. Play to the line, good keep, a coin. He'll work it down low. Right wing side got one to the net, and that was blocked away. I think the Jackets, Nikita got in the middle of that one. And it's cleared out. And Dorsett now will send one into the corner. Mike Smith there to set it up. Plays it around. Gillies now down low. Dorsett is there. Now Dorsett getting worked over by Martin Hansel. They continue to battle for it. It's taken away by Adrian Acoin.
Well, the thing with the Phoenix guys is as good as that month of February was, I mean, really unable to create much separation. So they know that's the good thing. That the battle and the road has just begun. They put themselves in a good position just to be in the battle.
There's a 5-point separation between the Coyotes, who are in third in the West, and the ninth place Los Angeles Kings. Over the line, Jack Johnson's going to take it to the net. He's stopped that time by Smith. Good angle off play that time with the youngster David Runblad. And the Coyotes will look to get it out. Turnover here. Broussard gives it. Shot on and a stop by Smith. Great look there by the Jackets' R.J. Umberger. And now Taylor Pyatt will dump one right back in.
I think that's something that Runblad's going to have to get used to, just the speed. There's so much faster paced here at the NHL level. It was Johnson who took him wide.
Well, he went down to Portland, did Runblad. Played a lot for the Portland Pirates, but he's been up and down, hasn't played in a while, and I would imagine it's very difficult to adjust to the speed. And now you get a chance to get into the lineup, and we'll see how he does here tonight against Columbus, as this one is a play to the line. They keep it. Now it's taken away by Ekman Larson. Good step up play that time with the defenseman before the Blue Jackets to turn it the other way. John Moore rolling puck in behind the net. Smith will steer it around. And Rafi Torres, simple little chip there for Damon Lanco, who will flip it off on right wing into the corner for Brule. Rafi Torres to the line. Yandle. Yandle thought about it. He'll get a shot away, and that was blocked away. Caromed off the stick of Aaron Johnson and all the way back deep.
That's a textbook dump, though, there by Damon Lanco. Get a little bit of support in on that forecheck. You recover that puck back. Rafi Torres doing a nice job as well.
From that upended, play rolls on. Now Yandle can't keep it. And so Korpakoski hustles back, trying to get it out. He can't. Good keep there by the Jackets, right through the crease, and looking for the deflection that time was Gillies. Gillies is in front of the net. At the line, Petr Tuukka. But the Jackets sloppily on that sequence. And so now the other way it goes, and it's flipped right back in. Now Mike Smith is going to get a handle penalty here, and it looks like the Jackets are going to go to the power play. No score tonight, 9:13 remaining in the first. He's been terrific, but it got a little sloppy there, so he goes for delay of game at 10:47.
Back-to-back delay of game penalties. He had one last game, too, against the Calgary Flames here again early, and that one really wasn't even close. So a monster penalty kill coming up as you look at the Blue Jackets' power play. Just outstanding numbers 2 for their last 7. 16th overall in the National Hockey League, but good as of late.
Jack Johnson, one of the 2-point men, and he'll man that right point. Here's a chance and a cross. Johnson tried to set it up. It's knocked free. Rick Nash will play it out of the left wing corner. Now Nash back out high. Works it to the line. Wisniewski. His shot is on, and it's stopped by Smith. And he does not offer up a rebound.
Wow, they love to give that puck. Rick Nash is the quarterback of this power play from the side wall. They're always looking to give it to him. And he puts this puck right back to Wisniewski. There's an innocent shot on net, but when you have traffic in front, makes it real tough on a goaltender. Umberger right in front, not off to the side, right in front of Mike Smith, who had no idea where that puck was.
Puck rolls all the way down the length of the ice. Good look at it there as Jack Johnson just set it up in behind the net. Derek Brassard now for Columbus. Flips the Nash. Columbus with a little bit of momentum, not only on the power play, but also they've had the last 4 shots. Here's a turnover as Doan brings it in over the line, but he played himself offside. So the faceoff comes out.
Nice job there by Damon Lanko. Up ice. Causing all sorts of problems there for Rick Nash. Stands him up. Little feed there, the captain Shane Doan. Offside is the call.
Mark the faceoff back at center ice. So Fetter Tootin will set it up. Paired defensively with Nikita Nikitin right now for Columbus. Letestu brings it back and over the line. Far side. Brassard will play it in behind the net for Letestu. Around for Prosper. To the line. Tootin shoots and might have hit a player in front. Might have turned off Chris Summers. Down to the line. Tootin. For Prosper. Across it goes. They work it to the front looking for a high deflection. That time Letestu was there. Now back of the line holding onto it. Nikitin. Into the corner. Prosper. Try to work it to the front. It's underneath and cleared away that time by Martin Hanza with 27 seconds left in the power play.
Real nice job there by Summers. They got traffic in front. Crossball doing a real nice job in front of Mike Smith. Summers can't do anything about it, so he jumps in front of him. But when you do that, you now have 2 guys screening the goaltender. You better block that puck, and he did, in fact, twice.
Played in behind the net, chasing it down is Lori Korpakoski. Back out high, Ekman Larson, and he'll chip it in behind the net. Boyd Gordon going after it. Penalty is now over, so Vermette is out of the box. He was serving the binder to Mike Smith. R.J. Umberger, 2 Columbus shots, but they fail to score. We're talking about their power play as of late. That's a huge lift for the Phoenix Coyotes as Rick Nash through center. Gets it in over the line, Brassard. Rink wide, Umberger, shot. That's blocked away by Roosevelt. Michael Roosevelt looks to move it along, and now out of the zone, Whitney. 3-on-2 developing for the Coyotes. Verbata with it, drops it. Hansel to Verbata, over the top of the net. Steve Mason came out to challenge, but here's a 3-on-1 the other way. Nash over the line, Umberger to Nash, and that's deflected off a stick and out of play.
Oh, Ekman Larson wanted that puck, but Verbata misses the net. 3-on-1 the other way. Great Tippett won't be happy about that. Here's the play right here. Nice 4-on-2. Ekman Larson, you see him in the far left. He wanted that puck. Verbata misses the net, but then it's a 3-on-1. The other way, and Rick Nash leading the charge. You gotta hit the net.
Back of the line, upended that time of the play was Adrian Akoi. No penalty called. Brule gets it in over the line. Drops it. Yandle. Wrister blocked. Rebound in front. It's a loose puck. Where is it? Still no whistle. It's underneath a couple of players. Coyotes banging away at it, so are the Blue Jackets, and it's finally clear.
Outstanding job by the referee to find that puck. No quick whistle. An even better play there by the Coyotes. Up ice, Brule to Keith Yandle. Keith Yandle had the beaver tail going. He wanted that puck.
Adrian Acoin will get it out of the zone. Rafi Torres. Back over the line, Brule. Right back to Torres with a chance in front. It's just deflected wide by Antoine Vermette. Penalty coming up here.
That was it right there. Wide open cage for Vermette.
Delayed call. Goes down low and in behind the net. Vermette chasing it down. So is Whitney. Whips it back to the line. Brulé, open look. Shoots. And that's stopped. And we get a whistle. And I think Steve Mason might have been a little bit shaken up on that play. Well, they're buzzing now, are the Coyotes, and they'll go to the power play. Play.
Well, 2 minutes. You'll feel shame, but here's the penalty right here. Nice feed from Rafi Torres. There's the hook on Vermette. Dorsett may have saved a goal. Nice shot there by Brulé. Vermette right in front of Mason. That was the shot. I'll slow it down for you there. That stung Mason a little bit.
So Whitney with the puck, he'll send it across for Bada. Tried to jam it towards the net, and it's cleared out of there. DiPiano lost it. Turnover. Chance, side of the net, and stopped by Smith.
Well, the Coyotes coaching staff talked about more movement on this power play was going to be the key. Get that penalty kill moving. Get the puck moving, bodies moving, defensemen jumping in and out. And see if that won't shake things up a little bit here.
We'll see if they can get it done here on this first Arizona Lottery Powerball power play this evening. Whitney sends it around. Hansel. And behind the net. Brulé goes after it. Trying to jam it to the right point, but Whitney can't set it up, and it's turned the other way. Fetter Tootin over the line. And he drags it into the corner. Nice bit of penalty killing there by Tootin, and the Coyotes will set it up. 4.5 to go here in the period, and another minute to go in this power play. Going to the corner. For Pekoski, upended. Puck will come across. Yandle comes in. Puts it back out high. Whitney to the middle. Here's a chance. And Vermette's shot is blocked away by Jack Johnson. Now Vermette holding on to it. Korpikoski to the line. Whitney. Ari Korpikoski into the corner. Boom, trying to set it up there for Vermette. Antoine Vermette. Nice flip to the line for Whitney. To Yandle. Yandle to the middle. Doan. Now Whitney, or excuse me, Yandle holding onto it in the corner, but it's knocked away and out of the zone for Derek McKenzie. Flipped along, and Nash now, here he comes. Short-handed, he shoots, and he scores. Another shorty, and the Columbus Blue Jackets have taken a 1-0 lead.
Oh, what a shot there by Rick Nash, and that is the last guy. But here is the Coyotes. They're having all sorts of problems. Just beating that puck up. Out the puck goes Rick Nash. And he freezes Mike Smith. Quick little shot here. This is a thing of beauty. Thing of beauty. The second shorthanded goal allowed in the last two games by the Coyotes. First one against Calgary. Glenn Cross, bad angle shot. This one, much prettier play. Rick Nash is 23rd of the season.
Derek McKenzie along with John Moore assisting. Penalty is over. Coyotes watch the Blue Jackets go back to full strength. Short-handed goal of Nash, and it comes at 16-21. Bodker, the line. Now Roosevelt to Ekman Larson. Shot is on, but it's blocked away by Fetter Tootin.
Nice block there by Tootin.
Possible will flip one in.
And the Coyotes now, their power play, they're just thinking way too much. Thinking too much, squeezing the sawdust out of those sticks. They really just got to turn the brains off, outwork the penalty kill unit of the Columbus Blue Jackets and shoot that puck every opportunity they can.
Out of the zone it goes. Broussard in onto the line. Pull-up move. Hits the trailer. Shot. And a stop by Smith. Oh, are they finding the trailer? That time it was R.J. Umberger. Todd Richards is the head coach of the Columbus Blue Jackets. But took over in midseason, the former head coach of the Minnesota Wild.
He's got to be happy with this start here against the Coyotes. And this Columbus Blue Jackets, they're a loose team. They're out of the playoffs. They're still fighting for jobs. They're fighting for contracts and ice time. And this is a dangerous team to play at this stage of the game, and they know it. They can play spoilers, and they have as of late, I'll tell you that. Coyotes play the Jackets 2 out of the next 3 games. They're in Pittsburgh, and then a back-to-back situation against Columbus on Tuesday night.
Yandle locks up in the corner. A shot is taken from a sharp angle. The Mets going to try to get it out. Dona will work it back through center. And Lori Korpikoski going into the corner. Plays it in behind the net. Dome back out high. Yandle shoots. And that's blocked away. Got to get that shot off a little quicker. That time Umberger able to get the stick out in front. Well, don't forget, when the Coyotes win, you win at Papa John's. After every Coyotes win, you can celebrate with 50% off your online order to the next day at papajohns.com. Just type in the promo code Coyotes. Offer only available online on regular menu prices.
Well, back to work for the Coyotes. They've had some chances in this first period. You're going to shake that one off and back to work. This fourth line, Dave Tippett throws out. They have been good in this first period, bringing the energy.
Played right back and over the line. That time, Summers taking a run at McKenzie. Now in behind the net, McKenzie will leave it there. Early in this game, it was pretty much all Coyotes. They had some great rushes up ice. They had some good scoring chances against Steve Mason. And then they give up a shorthanded goal, and the Blue Jackets have slowly but surely gained the momentum here, and the goal has really elevated their play as this one is played all the way back, and we're going to whistle. I'm going to talk a little bit about some Coyotes defensemen as we take a look at tonight's Taco Bell text poll. Don't forget, you can text ABCRD to 36929. Who's been the Coyotes MVP on defense? A, Acoin. B, Ekman-Larsson. C, Klesla. Or D, Keith Yandle. Message and data rates may apply. They've all been very, very good. And in a lot of ways, for different reasons, Tyson.
All for different reasons. That's what makes up a good team. Everyone has a role on this team. Everyone has some value in that role. And right now, with Klesla skating the last few days, that would be a huge boost for this defensive core to get him back.
From behind the net, Martin Hansel leaves it there. Nobody down low for the Coyotes. Easy strip that time for the Blue Jackets, and out of the zone they go. Prostel, two on one, brings it in over the line. He shoots, and he sent it wide. Back to the front. They look for the deflection in front for Letestu. And now played all the way back. Rubato over the line. Hansel gets around the defender. Shoots. Stopped that time by Steve Mason.
Mason building some confidence as well as this first period goes along. He's had some help from his defensemen and forwards, really doing a nice job collapsing in front of him to eliminate those second and third opportunities. But that was a big save on Martin Hansel right there.
Under a minute to go in this opening period. And now we get a whistle here. Looks like a high sticking call.
Now we'll get a look at the replay here. High stick, Ekman-Larsson hits Broussard right in the yap.
Phoenix penalty, 23, 4 minutes, high stick.
So 4 minutes, he must have been leaking. So Ekman-Larsson draws blood. 4 minute penalty to kill, 42.9 seconds to go in the first. And this is a must. This is a must. They have to get the job done here. At least to finish this first period out.
Yeah, 42.9 remaining in the opening period. So the Coyotes penalty killing unit is out there. Columbus already with the game's lone goal, a specialty a team's goal, coming shorthanded. Back out high. Holding on to it. They try to work it to the middle. Nash gave it off into the corner for Fetter Tootin. Now back to the line for Nikitin. He'll send it across. Broussard to the line. Tootin. Is it off there? Now Tootin back out high. Coyotes need to get through these final 9 seconds. Tootin set one wide of the mark. And now Umberger will play it around, and this one will carry him out, and that's going to do it here for the first period of play. Well, they're starting to fall behind to begin games, Tyson, and that's not a good trend, and especially not a good trend when you allow a team to score a shorthanded goal.
No, absolutely. The power play has not cost them all year, but the last few games, it has really come back to bite them. I like the way the Coyotes started. They came out with a big push. They didn't execute. They couldn't capitalize on opportunities. Another shorthanded goal has made this game 1-0. They need to regroup, reset, and kill this next 3:18 left in this power play.
All right, end of one. Mark McLoone will be standing by with Gilbert Brulé. When we come back, A Nash shorthanded goal is giving Columbus a 1-0 lead. Brought to you by Jack in the Box. Love bacon? Then try the new BLT cheeseburger combo right now at Jack in the Box for just $4.99 plus tax.
Well, welcome back for the second period. 1-0 Jackets. But first, it's all about a homestand. After a quick two-game road trip, your Coyotes continue their playoff push with a three-game homestand. Go Wild Thursday versus Minnesota. Swim with the Sharks on Saturday in a key Pacific Division battle. And then next Monday, the Coyotes hunt down the Nashville Predators. Seats are available for all three games by calling 480-563-PUCK or logging on to phoenixcoyotes.com.
Little country hoedown with those Nashville Predators, fourth and final meeting a week from Monday night. Rick Nash, he was down with a shorthanded goal in the opening 20.
I might just wear the chaps for that one. Chaps in the cowboy hat. But first, the Coyotes, they better kill this penalty. 3:18 to go.
There's a great little place called the Bluebird Cafe in Nashville, Tennessee, if you ever get an opportunity to go there. And I guess I just plugged it, so there you go. A lot of great musicians have come through there.
Looking for a free appy, as usual, huh? Old alligator arm.
Wisniewski, take it away, Korpikoski. Here he comes. He's hooked on the play, and it rolls on.
Well, how about that play by Rick Nash? How fast is he? We all know how fast the torpedo is. He was shot out of a cannon, but he was caught from behind by Rick Nash.
Laid out and sent all the way up the ice. Jack Johnson there for the Columbus Blue Jackets. Wisniewski lays it along Letestu. Don't forget another 2:32 left in the Columbus power play. Side of the net. All the way back to the line it goes. Johnson playing that left point, and this one goes off netting. And we'll get a whistle and a stoppage of play. They've had quick starts to second periods as of late. Almost one here from the Corpedo.
Well, Corpedo looking for his fourth shorthanded goal, but it was Rick Nash who had the speed boots on. He catches Korpikoski from behind, and he doesn't take a penalty.
Good example, because he tried to lift the stick. Had he gone and hacked over the stick, it might have been a penalty.
Yeah, he'd be in the box, but good speed there by Rick Nash. It must run in the name.
I caught that. Puck played all the way down.
What are you laughing at?
Nothing.
Want to go for a fall?
I'm with
From here.
Tootin will dangle through the neutral zone. Plays it on the left wing. Jackets look to set it up. And this one is knocked away. Smart play that time by Adrian Acoin. So the Jackets back through center ice. Nash has it, lost it. They're a little bit disorganized here before Nash brings it right back it over the line. And it's flipped back towards the point, but nobody home for Nash or for Columbus, and it'll be played all the way back.
Nice job by the Coyotes holding that blue line, forcing Columbus, who does not want to dump that puck in.
Back it over the line, Jack Johnson sets it up left side or right side, Brassard. Derek Brassard trying to get it down low. Summers that time defending well. Back of the line, Wisniewski across. Jack Johnson, he shoots and he sent it over the top. And this one all the way back through center.
Oh, what a missile there by Johnson. That was Brassard right in front. How would you like that bullet flying chin high?
Brassard will get it back in over the line. Umberger now. And that's taken away. Bouncing puck in front. And Roosevelt will settle it down with 43 seconds left. Coyotes bring it back shorthanded. Over the line for Doan. Now Doan trying to get a shot away. That's knocked free. And Letestu the other way for Columbus. Pull-up move there. Into the corner it goes. Cam Atkinson got it back to the line. Crossbow now for Wisniewski. Across. And a shot is handled that time by Mike Smith. One shot so far on the double minor. Let's go downstairs, Mark McClune.
Yeah, I talked to assistant coach Jim Playfair coming out of the dressing room. He kind of echoed the two of your sentiments about working hard. The Coyotes need to work a little bit harder. They need to win more puck battles. They're getting beat too much at the top of the circle, and simply put, the defense needs to be better.
That's right. No question about it. Back to work. Hockey the hard way. That's the Coyotes slogan. We've seen it. We just haven't seen it consistently enough again here tonight.
By the way, we call Todd Walsh, we call him Walshy. Can we call Mark McClune maybe Clunesy?
Clooney.
Clooney, there you go.
George.
Over the line, Prosbold drops it that time, and a shot is stirred aside. Good look there for Cam Atkinson. Coyotes bring it right back. Penalty is over, so they kill off a double minor, which is one Columbus shot over the four-minute power play. Hansel in the corner. Gives it to Whitney now. Martin Hansel, and that's stirred aside. Left pad save. Here's another shot, and that's kicked aside. Coyotes trying to bring it in front of the Columbus goaltender.
Yeah, nice job by the Coyotes getting shots on net. Big saves. Two big saves by Mason, but nobody in front. There has to be someone in front of Mason to bang those rebounds home.
Adrian Acoin has it. Early second. Flips it for Yandle. Through the neutral zone. Gets it back and over the line. A shot up high. That time is handled by goaltender Steve Mason. Well, you can let the madness begin. Live from Los Angeles, it's the Pacific Life Pac-12 Tournament. Don't miss the drama, the upsets, and the excitement. Who will rise above the rest and punch their ticket to the NCAA tourney? The Pacific Life Pac-12 Tournament tips off Wednesday, 1 p.m. right here on Fox Sports Arizona, one of my favorite times of the year. Can't wait. Played him behind the net. I got to make sure I get into a brackets game with you.
Oh, that's like candy from a baby. Easy money.
Got to seek out all those Canadians. Way to the line. Good keep by Lebda. They work into the middle. And that's taken away as Rafi Torres will get it out, and he clears it all the way back to center.
I'd take Visa, MasterCard, American Express. I take it all, whatever. No coupons, though.
Back at center, Boyce. Yeah, Walshy's out there. Ekman-Larsson.
So wrong. He's not even here to protect himself.
Turnover. Nash. Now Broussard looking around. Across. Johnson shoots over the top of the net. Jack Johnson.
Another turnover for the Coyotes and just missed defensive responsibilities. In this Columbus Blue Jackets, the odd man rushes they've had and the chances, the open defenseman.
Nash the other way, here he comes, back it over the line. Nash to the net, he scores. Well, these defensive lapses can end at any time.
And this is ridiculous. I mean, this isn't even fair. He was going to get a penalty shot for this, I can guarantee you. And Rick Nash is not getting up. Oh, there he pops up now, but what a move.
Importantly, Mike Smith is still on the ice, too.
It was Chris Summers all over Rick Nash. At the end, he was, I think he was on his back, riding him all the way in to Mike Smith.
Now they're going to have a powwow, the officials.
The move here, right at the end. Just brings that out to the backhand. He's got that big reach, so big and strong. There's Summers all over him. Great set of mitts. That's a scary combination.
They're discussing this at the penalty box, and I would imagine the question is, was it goaltender interference?
Now, there's nothing to discuss on this one. This is a good goal by a great player. And if this counts, that's his 24th of the season. Got a shorthanded marker, partial breakaway, and
yeah, they better get it righted in a hurry here.
Well, you can't take teams for granted. You can't take anyone lightly. We talked about it in the open of the show. When you have a player like Rick Nash on your team, last place in the league or not, he makes them dangerous. Every time he steps on the ice, he has the ability to make something happen. You can't stop Rick Nash. You can only try to contain him. If you look there, Summers was draped all over him like a cheap suit, and he still couldn't get the job done. Rick Nash still finds a way to get that puck in the back of the net, brings it out wide, puts Summers, Smith, and the puck in the back of the net.
And it might be looking to see if the puck crossed the line before the net came off. And by the looks that we have shown you, if that is the case, it should be a good goal. Well, Mike Smith's been good tonight. He's not had a lot of support in front of him. Yeah. And that's boggling, mind-boggling. Maybe we should eliminate the Columbuses from the schedule and bring in the Detroits and the San Jose's. I mean, it continues to haunt.
Yeah, the Phoenix Coyotes, they seem to get up that much more against the good teams in the league, the Vancouvers, the Detroits, the San Jose's, just for fear of embarrassment. But, I mean, when you don't find a way to close these games out, I mean, these ones hurt. This stinks. And with Columbus, the next two out of three.
Get the word from our official Steve Cazzari.
After review, the puck enters the net before everybody else in the net's dislodged. It's a good goal.
So Rick Nash with two here tonight. And I think it's a good call.
Yeah, absolutely. So the Coyotes have dug themselves a hole once again. And this has really been the story the last five or six games for Phoenix. Falling behind, but never giving up. That's one thing this Coyotes team, it takes a little while to wake them up sometimes. But they always bounce back. They almost did the other night against Calgary. They just couldn't come all the way back. But these 2 points here tonight are huge.
So Rick Nash two and the Coyotes nothing here. Play back it over the line, Yandel. He'll try to get it out. He gets it to center for Korpikoski. But Testu takes that away. Atkinson will work it in over the line. Well, the Blue Jackets with all sorts of confidence. And this one is cleared all the way back to center ice. They defeated the big hit that time.
Huge hit by the captain, Shane Doan. Tootin goes down hard. And I think that's a message right in front of that Coyotes bench. Wake up, boys.
Sent over the line. Steve Mason to save there. It'll be moved out and right back through center ice. Gillies that time got drilled by Summers. And now right back and over the line it goes. Whitney holds. Whitney Rister trying to get it to the net and set just wide of the mark by Verbata. This one's going to be cleared all the way down. Runblad chases it and we get an icing call here. So arguably the best sequence of the night. And it all starts on a heavy hit from the captain.
Yeah, Shane Doan runs over Tootin. As I mentioned, sending a message, I think, to that whole bench. And then Summers gets involved as well with a big hit here on Gillies. Gillies, who gets caught watching the puck, have a seat. And here is the one we were talking about. Just a thing of beauty right there. Everybody on their feet at jobbing.com after that hit. Let's see if the Coyotes can't build some momentum after that.
Runblad has to chase this one down. Plays it to Summers. Hansel now flips it on right wing. Verbata gets it in over the line. Runblad has it. Goes wide. Now Runblad in behind the net. This one's taken away by Dorsett. And all the way back. And over the line that time. Big hit on McKenzie from Summers.
Oh, I like it. Summers and Gillies. Here we go.
Yeah, let's see what happens here. Chris Summers and Gillies going in the corner.
Oh, I love it. Throwing bombs.
Yeah, Chris Summers getting in some big whacks. And Gillies now coming right back.
You're going to go. You might as well go. I'm not sure Summers has had too much experience at this. I like what I see. He's tied up in a pretzel right now, though.
He's trying to get that right hand free, and he does. Gillies is a tough kid. Picked up from the Minnesota Wild. And good for Chris Summers, who took a cue from Captain Shane Doan.
Well, and Summers hit Gillies again in the corner. There it was. Oh, punch in the face contest.
Game for the Coyotes. In a fight, that's because Rick Nash has had his way here tonight and brings us to tonight's Coors Light freeze can.
Here it was. Just went to review. A speedy Rick Nash. Makes a beautiful move there. You can see the puck go across the line before the net is dislodged. What a play by Rick Nash and the Coors Light Freeze Camp.
Coors Light Freeze Camp is brought to you by Frost Brewed Coors Light. They were looking, they reviewed that goal just to see if the puck had crossed the line before the net had been dislodged. Rundblad will flip it along. Ekman Larson now, and it's cleared all the way back to center.
I'll never forget when I went to Japan, I told my Japanese team that I was Rick Nash, and just to get a little extra treatment. I'll tell you what, now you can see why I said what I said. This guy is just a beast.
I didn't realize you scored 35 in that league that one year. Ekman Larson across, broken stick Whitney. That's just lousy luck there for the Wizard, and it's cleared back to center.
Yeah, that's par for the course here tonight. The Coyotes, though, as Dave Tippett always talks about, you earn your bounces and you earn the confidence, and the Coyotes have not done that here tonight.
And behind the net, Ekman Larson. Credit Columbus, because they looked tentative early in this one, and then they really got it going. As Rundblad will play it along, and now Antoine Vermette to center for Ekman Larson. Back and over the line, works it to Vermette. Whitney at the line. Power play out there for another 41 seconds. A chance in front. Whitney scores! Ray Whitney's got him on the board. It's 2-1.
Well, that's how you get it done. Wow. What a play there by the captain, Shane Doan. Nice little drop pass to a wide open Ray Whitney. And that's his 20th of the season for the Wizard. Right there, the captain, he blocks that original shot, I believe by Rundblad, puts it between the legs of the Jackets defender, and Whitney with a backdoor tap in all alone for number 20 of the season for the Wizard, Ray Whitney. It is now 2-1. That is a monster goal.
So Whitney is 20th, as you mentioned, 8:19, the time of the power play goal from Doan and Rundblad. And the Coyotes get right back into it. Yandel wraps it around. Bouncing puck is going to be taken away. Boyd Gordon. Haven't called his name all that much here tonight as he flips it into the corner. Played in behind the net. Bodker is there. And now it's taken away. Gordon. Bodker's going to try to go after it. Penalty coming up here, and it's going to go against the Coyotes. Minor penalty coming up. Wisniewski.
That's too bad. That's going to suck any life. After that goal of Ray Whitney, the Coyotes now back on the kill. That next shift, so important. It's going to be Bodker.
Okay, penalty 89, 2 minutes holding.
It's going to be holding. There's Bodker on the chase on Brassard. Takes his hand off the stick.
Yeah.
Easy call there. That's almost automatic. And you keep your eye on Ray Whitney. We got ISO'd here in the ISO camp. Pretty easy. Kids watching at home, it'll give and go, and then go to the net.
That's where you score the goals. So the Coyotes, a penalty killing unit back out there. They killed off the double minor to end the opening period in the second. So the Coyotes shorthanded here for another minute 47.
Yeah, way too much penalty kill time here. You lose guys on the bench. Guys that don't kill penalties, they lose their legs.
Play back of the line, Jack Johnson looking around. Gives it to Letestu. Back out high, Johnson. Now Jack Johnson looking for that lane. Got one towards the net. Loose puck just sent wide. Out of the zone and played all the way back to center. The captain, Shane Doan, has company. He's got Ekman Larson. Across to Ekman Larson, but he can't pull the trigger. And the puck goes in behind the net. Wisniewski will get it out. And this one all the way back down where it'll be played behind the net by Yandel. Wraps it around, but he can't. Yep, he got it out of the zone. That's because Wisniewski couldn't play it.
Yeah, just by a hair. I like the urgency with the Coyotes right now.
Over the line, Wisniewski will play it into the corner. Rolls in behind the net. Nash is there. Rick Nash setting it up. Broussard back to Nash. Nash in front, and that's knocked away. And Yandel will find the outlet, and he clears down the length of the ice.
Well, Rick Nash all over that puck. So dangerous every time he gets on the ice.
Played at center. Yandel, and he'll find the opening and send down the lane. 18 seconds to go on the Columbus power play to center. Over the line to Keaton. He lost it. We saw the freight train Doan right in front of him that time. Coyotes are going to take it away. Chance here. Lanko in over the line, but we're going to get a whistle. I believe offside.
I can't believe that wasn't a penalty. I believe that was Roosevelt, who got taken down after stripping the puck from the Blue Jackets on the blue line. Well, here's the replay. See Roosevelt on the right of your screen. He's going to steal the puck, and off he goes. Take it down right there. A couple whacks. No call.
Bodker is out of the penalty box, and the Coyotes will chip it in. As Moore touches up, and we get a whistle here on the icing call. Just one shot on that Columbus power play.
That nice kill there for the Coyotes. Now it's back to work. Icing call. This line's going to stay out. Big faceoff coming up. Back to work, though, now for the Coyotes to try and recapture that momentum.
Ekman Larson will wrap it around. Coyotes look to get it out. Hansel. Now Verbata flips it right back and over the line. Tootin up ice. Angled off in the corner that time. Ekman Larson down low. Worked it to the middle. Dorsett gives it back. Tootin with a shot. Batted away that time by Smith. Coyotes can't get it out. Well, the other night against Calgary, I don't know how many times they turned the puck over 5 feet inside the blue line. Here's one. Dorsett right to the net. And he's stopped by Smith.
What a save by Mike Smith. Another turnover.
Gotta help out the goaltender here. Puck still inside the zone. All of this off a failed clearing attempt. Dorsett in behind the net. Sends it across. Tootin. Coyotes fans getting restless here at Jobbing.com Arena. Derek Dorsett.
Well, that was as bad of a turnover as you're ever going to see. That was a pepperoni pizza with extra cheese right there for Dorsett, who had time to re-pick up his stick.
Still inside the zone, and they just can't get it out. Finally, back to center ice. Verbata. And he'll send one deep.
Well, get off the ice and get a fresh set of troops out there.
Now the prime line heads to the bench, replaced by Lanco's line with Torres and Brulé. Sent into the corner. Good lockup. Lockup by Adrian Acoin. And in behind the net, it's Keith Yandel. Closing it on 7 minutes remaining in the second period. Yandel up the ice. Got a wide open Brulé. Takes it all the way down. And a shot is steered that time by Steve Mason. Now the other way, Broussard. One on one. Good kick away that time by Lanko, but he can't get it out. John Moore, his shot wide of the mark. Goes in behind the net. Nash. Back out high, Broussard. Nash to the front, and they can't finish it off. And now Rafi Torres will backhand one deep, and that line heads to the bench. Rick Nash out there. Back it over the line. One-on-one against Ekman Larson. Taken away. And Doan the other way. Hustling it back at a 4-on-3. Doan over the line. He shoots. Stop. Rebound. They score! What a follow-up there! Lauri Korpikoski. And the Corpedo is tied it at 2.
Well, we talked about it. You gotta be there for those rebounds. And Shane Doan, he's not shooting to score. He is shooting for a rebound. He gets the puck, good backside pressure. Watch the captain. He rumbles down this left side, and he shoots to that left pad for a rebound. And they do this. He takes the puck right off of Rick Nash. Outstanding job. They do this in practice all the time. Right off the pad to an oncoming forechecker, and there's Lori Korpikoski, the torpedo. He goes hard to that right post for his 14th tuck of the season. And again, we talk about it, the ability of this Coyotes team to come from behind.
Well, they're reviewing it here. 14th of the season for Korpikoski. Goal's going to stand. We're ready to go. It comes at 13:50.
Yep, just making sure.
Looking at the penalty expiration time, we are told. Back it over the line. That time, Vermette gets handled on a heavy check at the blue line. Back it over the line. Go the Blue Jackets. Out of the corner it goes. Back of the line. Set behind the net. Rundblad after it. And he'll flip it along. Korpikoski in behind the net. He'll set it up. Rundblad looking around, and he goes right back for Summers. Now Rundblad gets checked off the puck. Wisniewski back out high. Played in behind the net. Back of the line, Wisniewski takes a shot. That hit a stick. And again, the Columbus Blue Jackets get a good offensive cycle going before it's cleared all the way back to center ice.
And I might add the captain, Shane Doan, he's been involved on both goals. Two assists in this game. But how about the hits? It really woke up this Coyotes bench.
And then Summers followed up with a couple of big hits in a fight. As this one has played all the way back. John Moore. All the way back to center ice. Dorsett has it. Rinkwai. Back it over the line. Try to drop it in front for Letestu. And this one is batted away. Good clear by Yandle to the corner. And out of the zone for Taylor Pyatt. Pyatt over the line. Pyatt trying to go strong to the net. He dipped that shoulder, but nobody there to receive the puck. Pyatt, good battle as it's sent in behind the net. Now Bodker chasing after it.
This is Coyotes hockey right here. Doing the dirty work down low, just wearing this Jackets team out. Not the fancy tic-tac-toe plays. It's grinding on those boards.
Back of the line, Yandle is shot, and that never made it to the net. Kind of spun up high in front. Now Bodker. To the line it goes. McCoy to Yandle. Yandle lost it. Letestu will fight it all the way back, and he dumps all the way down inside the Phoenix zone. Nearly a turnover picked by Hansel. Over the line, Whitney. Whitney, rink wide, trying to get it to the middle, and it's underneath Tootin before Rick Nash will take it away. Brassard now the other way in a one-on-one. Pull-up move there. Brassard leaves it. Looking for Nash, but it's picked by the Wizard, Ray Whitney. And Yandle will play. Oh. Great move there. Whitney over the line. Cutting into the net. Whitney trying to get a shot away. Goes back out high. And a shot just wide by Roosevelt. Roosevelt got upended along the far boards. And here we go. 3-on-1 Columbus. Wisniewski over the line. Shoots. He sent it over the top. And the Coyotes will race back with it.
Oh, trip.
Over the line. Delayed call. Hansel drops it. Bravada shoots. And Mason took a peek behind. Power play coming up for the Coyotes. They get a pair. First it was Whitney. And then the torpedo. So the Coyotes go to the power play with an opportunity to take the lead.
Well, here we go. The power play. Red rot the first time. There's the penalty right there. No question about that. Led to a 2-on-1 the other way also. Ray Whitney up the ice, but they capitalized on their second power play opportunity with a beauty. Ray Whitney got this whole thing kick-started.
Rundblad at the point, he can't handle it, and so it'll be moved along for Oliver Ekman-Larsson. They are the point men. Up front, it's Verbata, along with Whitney and Hansel. Played back and over the line. Hansel's going to try to chase it down into the corner. Big hit there, and it gets past Ekman-Larsson and cleared. And now Hansel having words with Dorsett as the puck goes back up the ice. Taken away by Fetter Tootin and cleared down the length of the ice. So Ekman Larson will play it in behind the net. Verbata skates it out. Around the boards it goes. Kept at the line by Ekman Larson, tries to jam away at it. Verbata's there into the corner for Whitney. Now back of the line, Ekman Larson across for Runblad. Runblad down low for Whitney. Now Whitney for Verbata. Out of the net, Whitney out of that corner, the left wing side, back to the line. Ekman Larson with a shot, just caroms wide. And it's cleared out.
All right, idea with Hansel and Verbata right in front. You got to shoot the puck. Simplify things.
Nice move, Korpikoski got it down low. Got it away by Mason. Vermetel wrap it around. Left point, Ekman Larson across. Yandel, nice feather feed out high. Ekman Larson, his shot is blocked away. Tootin trying to clear it. Good block play that time. Ekman Larson keeping the zone for Yandel. Ekman Larson down low. Korpikoski, rink wide. Ekman Larson down on his knees that time as we go under a minute to go in this second period. Power play is over. Out of the box is Nash. Goes in behind the net. Back out high, a chance, and Ekman Larson fired it wide. Yandel, good keep, flips it to Doan. Doan to the net, and he with a shot that's steered by Mason. Now rink wide, Korpikoski to a coin, and this one deflects, and we'll get a faceoff inside the Columbus zone. 2-2. The score late in the second. It's time now to take a look at the report card, and it's presented by Farmers Insurance. Tonight we take a closer look at a couple of Coyotes. Consecutive games played. Yandel with those 238. Vermette at 246. Vermette's total would be 381, including tonight. But when he was traded from Ottawa to Columbus, he was on the roster, but he didn't make it in time for the game, so it was a break in his consecutive games played, kind of like a paper type of thing. He would be at 381.
Both those guys so durable, and that is a good thing. You pick up a guy like Antoine Vermette, you know you can count on him game in and game out. Plays through pain, you know, he sucked it up a few nights, battled through. And
what's it like playing against your old team?
Oh, it's fun. It is fun. It's nerve-wracking. You want to get it over with. I mean, it happens so quick for Vermette. Typically you have to wait, you know, more than a week, you know, to get it done. But it is nerve-wracking. Would it ever be nice for Vermette to get on the board here?
Back through center, Vermette's going to chase one down. A dozen seconds remaining in the second period. Well, the Coyotes have drawn even with the Blue Jackets. Jack Johnson with five to go. This one's going to be taken away by Roosevelt and cleared back to center, and time will run out. And the second period is history. So 2-2 the score through 40. Coming up, Mark McLoon will talk with Lori Korpikoski. We'll take a look around the NHL big game tonight in San Jose. And we'll also have the stats and highlights. So through two, all of a sudden it's tied.
Well, we've been ripping this power play apart, and it was the power play that got this team on the board and back in this game. Ray Whitney with a beauty feed from Shane Doan, and then help up the Korpikoski goal. Just another thing of beauty set up by the captain, who has two assists in this game. He has been a guy that has been leading by example. But yep. 20 miles, 20 smiles, Matt.
Yeah, Shane Doan really got it going on the physical side, and it seemed to lift the Phoenix Coyotes. Lori and Mark when we come back to Chopping.com Arena. Coyotes hockey on Fox Sports Arizona is brought to you by Jack in the Box. Love bacon? Then try the new BLT cheeseburger combo right now at Jack in the Box for just $4.99 plus tax. And by Sanderson Ford, Arizona's largest Ford dealership. Welcome back. Lori Korpikoski got his 14th to tie the game at 2-2 back at the 13:50 mark Ray Whitney got the team on the board prior to that with his 20th at 8:19 power play goal. So we're 2-2. Don't forget, you can talk hockey on FoxSportsArizona.com. Join in for a live web chat during the Coyotes-Penguins game Monday. You can ask Jody Jackson about the team, and it's pushed to the playoffs. It's Ask the Expert, presented by Jack in the Box, Monday starting at 5 on FoxSportsArizona.com. That's where the Coyotes head after this one. They'll be on their way to Pittsburgh tomorrow. We'll join you from Consol Energy Center on Monday night.
What a building that is. That's going to be a fun game and a good test for this Coyotes team. But first, 20 minutes. Probably the biggest 20 minutes since Christmas.
Have to agree with that one as this one is turned over and back it over the line. Letestu pull up move and he just missed wide. Look there, speaking of Pittsburgh, a former Penguin with a bid there on Mike Smith. Now wraparound is snuffed out at the last second by Yandle. And Korpikoski in behind the net in the battle. Columbus buzzing here to open up this third period of play. 40 seconds in the books. And now taking it away is Shane Doan.
Columbus, we talked about it. You know they're loose and they're going to take great pleasure in being spoilers in the last 17 games that they play this season. And the Coyotes face them again Tuesday night.
Roosevelt over the line, flips it into the corner. Ray Whitney down there, Roosevelt as well. Now Martin Hansel. Hansel strong-arming it to the line. Ekman Larson got one on, and that's just deflected wide. Roosevelt. Now Martin Hansel. On the line, Verbata. Tried to set it up for Whitney out high in that high slot for a deflection. Now back in the line, Whitney holds. Whitney across, a shot on, a stop, and rebound is smothered by Steve Mason.
That was a tired line of the Columbus Blue Jackets. The Coyotes knew it, and they tried to take advantage. Good shot there. Roosevelt rips that one through traffic in front. Big Martin Hansel. But Mason, he sucks up that rebound.
Good front net presence. We've talked a lot about the playoff push. Monday, we mentioned that game, Pittsburgh, Columbus the following night. And then Tyson referenced that three-game homestand, Minnesota, San Jose, and Nashville.
Well, that San Jose game, that is going to be a fun one. I'll tell you that. San Jose right now 2 points back of the Coyotes for first place in the division.
Bodker on the turnover will bring it up ice for Boyd Gordon. Soft flip to the right wing corner. Pyatt is after it. And Broussard will turn the other way as the Blue Jackets bring it up ice. Sent deep this time and into the corner by James Wisniewski, but Roosevelt is there and he'll move it to center. Intended for Boyd Gordon. Breakup play that time. Earl Boyce doing a nice job. Forcing the Coyotes back inside of their own zone. And now deflecting it is Lanco right back to the Columbus blue line. Boyce. Back to center ice. Turn the other way and we get a whistle here on the offside. We've been referencing Michael Roosevelt, talking about how well he's played defensively. But how about the other night against the Calgary Flames? Getting it on the offense.
And a big goal too for the Phoenix Coyotes. That's his first of the season. Does so many things right on the back end. You got to give him a little love on the front end. Roosevelt getting involved again here tonight.
Back of the line, knocked away, Rafi Torres.
Oh, Rafi Torres, he just blew a tire there at the blue line. Otherwise, he was gonzo.
And now Runblad in the corner, a backhand one all the way back to center ice. Brett Lebda, the former Notre Dame Fighting Irish player, will send one in behind the net. Irish have had a bit of a rough year this year as Runblad will bring it along. Crosses center, he'll send one in. Mason the save there, big rebound, but it's cleared out in the corner by Wisniewski. He got stripped in behind the net to the front. Doan is there and he's stopped by Mason.
Oh, that's a big save there by Mason and a heads up play. He follows that puck. Korpikoski Gets them moving.
Gillies. And he sent it over the top of the net. I don't think Keith Yandle knew where the puck was that time. Yandle at his own blue line. Gets it out. Vermette now. Zone entry on right wing. Played out of the corner and given right away. R.J. Umberger. And in behind the net, it's Steer there. Giveaway. Boyce. Stopped that time by Smith. And he holds on to get a faceoff.
And another turnover there by Keith Yandle. There's been a few. There's the shot there by Runblad. Coyotes in on that forecheck turnover. Here's Koprakoski. Watch Mason. He knows Shane Doan. Look how quick he was. He was down. He had to respect the wraparound by Koprakoski. And then he pops right up and fronts the shot from the captain, Shane Doan. Well, Mason has been very solid in this hockey game, particularly in that first period.
Flipped out of the zone and trying to chase it all the way down is Whitney. Hansel. And it's cleared out of the zone by Columbus. Now Prosper. And dumped right back in by Letestu. Around the boards it goes. Roosevelt is there. And now Bravada tries to get it out. Tootin can't keep the zone. Karam's back to center. Turn the other way. Back it over the line. Now Roosevelt finds Whitney up the ice. Whitney will hold on to it. Looks for some help. Bravada to the corner. Trying to set it up. Letestu took it away. And it's turned out of there by Nikita Nikitin. To center for Prosper. Into the corner, John Moore. Now Dorsett. Tied up by Boyd Gordon. Those two players battle for it. Derek McKenzie comes away with it. Nice feed to Moore. And that was blocked away. Bodker got in the middle of that one. Using that speed, back the other way. He drops it, a shot, and a glove save. Steve Mason.
Holy Hollywood. That's Grant Fuhr style right there. By Mason. Nice shot by Gordon.
Thought you were going to give me a holy jump in there.
I wouldn't go that far.
Oh, do that.
No, I would get abused if I stole the great Darren Pang's one-liner. But what a drop pass there by Bodker. And there she is. Look at the Grant Fuhr Hollywood save.
Are you saying he has one-liner that it's a one-liner?
That's a beauty. And Mason catches with that offhand. Most goaltenders typically catch with the left hand. He's a righty.
Brule bumps and keeps the zone. Gilbert Brule into the corner. Back of the line, Runblad. Trying to get a shot away. That's blocked. Good keep by Runblad. He'll get it right back. Skates in. He shoots in a save on the glove that time from Steve Mason.
Well, I'm not sure you're going to beat Mason to the glove side. You might want to change things up a little bit if you're the Phoenix Coyotes and work that blocker. Traffic. Good job here by Runblad. Good presence and patience. He brings that puck in up towards the ladies' tees and lets it fly. He waits for the traffic in front to set.
Good to get the shot through.
Yeah. Real nice job by Runblad, who's starting to settle in here as this period goes along. He was a little shaky in the first period. Got run a few times, maybe got woken up a little bit. He's been good. He's got an assist as well. So 2 points in three games this season for Runblad.
Speaking of assists, they've added an assist to Derek Brassard on the second Rick Nash goal. Into the corner, Bodker. Gets it off there for Taylor Pyatt. High up to the line, Runblad is there. Nice little moves. Skates in. Runblad shoots and he's stopped by Mason.
Well, he must have hurt me. He was snipping blocker side that time. And that is the Runblad. And the reason the Coyotes got him. The offensive upside right there. What a move on the blue line.
Patience.
He's shaking Bakes. That was Gillies. And then dances in with the big shot.
Summers in behind the net. Looks up ice, that's picked off. Good play by R.J. Umberger. This one's taken away by Shane Doan. Doan and Vermette backing over the Columbus blue line. Tootin that time. It takes a bump from Doan. In behind the net, Korpikoski. And now Mason will steer for Fetter. Tootin in behind the net. Picked off, but now the Jackets to center. Brassard. And that gets dumped into the corner. So the Blue Jackets on a line change. Oliver Ekman-Larsson will bring it out. Stretch pass through the neutral zone, intended for Doan. He'll go to the bench. So now the Coyotes change it up.
And you got to give Jimmy Playfair and Dave Tivitt some credit. I mean, Rundblad struggled early in this hockey game, but they stuck with him, and he's gotten better.
Prospel's shot blocked away. And out of the zone it goes. Ekman-Larsson had to put on the brakes there. And now Hansel back to play it for Michael Roosevelt. Yeah, there's something to be said about that, and especially for a youngster trying to gain a little confidence. Into the corner, Prospel now in a battle with Michael Roosevelt.
You've got to have patience, and I guess more than anything, I mean, this top four for the Coyotes on the back end, they have played a boatload of hockey down the stretch, and that's only going to continue until healthy bodies get back healthy. Wesla back skating. As you take a look at Rundblad there, 2 points in three games this season. There's the move. He's shaking bakes around Gillies. Little stutter step there, head up. And he's looking to that blocker side, trying to sneak one in over the glove.
Earlier in the game too, Tyson, we had that sequence. We showed it in slow motion of Brule with his head up all the way, getting a shot on goal. And Rundblad doing a nice job there. Gillies will take it away. Here come the Blue Jackets. They set it up in behind the net. Dorsett. Over to McKenzie. Now McKenzie skates in. Dorsett tried to deflect it there. It bounces into the corner.
Hansel. No stick. Martin Hansel.
Goes in behind the net. Nice cutoff move there by Ekman-Larsson. And Verbato will get it out as he flips it over. Wisniewski. And the Jackets will set it up deep inside of their own zone.
Real nice job defensively by the Phoenix Coyotes, using their body and body position to hold off the forecheckers of the Jackets.
Boyce deep, that time on Summers, and it'll come free as Rundblad.
Oh.
Over the line, Brule tried to dangle, and it's turned the other way. Back it over the line, Aaron Johnson, but it's taken off his stick by Summers. And now we get a whistle. Rafi Torres that time trying to take a run at the Blue Jacket player. That's a game of inches. Ooh. We're back. Time now for the game summary and a 2-2 tie here tonight in Glendale.
Well, it was the Rick Nash show early in this hockey game. A shorty right there. Top cheese over the glove of Mike Smith. And then Rick Nash again off to the races. See you later. And good luck stopping this one. 61 barreling down on you. It was reviewed, but deemed a good goal. But then it was Coyotes on the power play. Shane Doan to Ray Whitney. That was a thing of beauty. And then Shane Doan again. The shot pass off the left pad. Korpikoski going hard to the net. Bingo bango, 2-2.
Well, the captains in this one for both teams have been very good. That brings us to tonight's Hastings and Hastings on ice leader. It's about time. Rick Nash with those 2 points. Shane Doan setting up both Coyotes goals and both with 3 shots apiece.
I'll do as I do, not as I say, has been the story here tonight. Leading by example.
At the line it goes. This one, score! Deflected in front. And the Blue Jackets jump back in front.
It shows you the importance of face-offs. And Vermette, who's been so good in the circle, loses this one clean. And this goes off of the stick of Roosevelt. Take a look in front right there. Takes a hop over the blocker of Mike Smith. So good things happen when you shoot the puck. Nikita McKeaton, his fourth of the season.
So the Coyotes now trail by one. They all count. It's unfortunate when you get the bad bounce as McKenzie will send one into the corner. Rushing to the loose puck in behind the net and following up beautifully is McKenzie. Leaves it there for Brassard. Now Dorsett tried to get it to the front. It's taken away, and out of the zone is going to be Lori Korpikoski as he gets it back to center. Dorsett. And now turning with it is Keith Yandle. Yandle over the line. Tried to take a shot. He fanned on it. Play back of the line. Boyd Gordon. Good keep there. Shane Doan. Bumped off the puck there. And played right back in by Letestu. Out of the zone, Pyatt now. Breaking in over the Columbus blue line. And Pyatt will play it in behind the net for Boyd Gordon. Pyatt takes it away. Try the wraparound. It's in front. It's loose. It just sent wide. Bodker to the middle. Gordon tried to get a shot away. Good stick that time by Cam Atkinson as the puck is played in behind the Blue Jackets net. Taylor Pyatt in a battle, and Atkinson will flip this one to safety and all the way back inside the Coyotes blue line.
A real nice shift there by Taylor Pyatt. Such a big man, and when he makes up his mind with the puck, he wants to go to the net. There is no stopping him.
Nash steals it, feeds it along for Fetter Tootin. Batted away that time by Mike Smith. To the corner. Now behind the net, Umberger tied up by Martin Hansel. This one's taken away by Radim Verbata, but it's poked away as Umberger sets it up again. He got run by Hansel. Taken away by Verbata as he gets it through center. Whitney now trying to get around the defender. Whitney to the net. He got pulled down.
Oh, so close. I thought we were going to see a penalty shot.
Coyotes will go to the power play. Whitney yanked down. Columbus leading it by one.
Nikita in the box of the Coyotes will be on the power play here with 8.5 left in the third period. And yes, the Coyotes are down right now, but not out because they've had a number of comebacks in recent history. Jody Jackson with you, getting set for our postgame show, Coyotes Live, presented by CenturyLink. Let's take a look at them. You remember against the LA Kings, down 3-0, coming back to win in a shootout 5-4, similar against Calgary, down and then winning in the shootout 4-3. Guys, we'll have to see how this unfolds because we know that they're capable of it.
Well, the game on the line, Jody, and we'll see if they can get it tied here. Hansel has it, flips it to Runblad. Out of the corner, Whitney, back to Runblad. Oliver Ekman-Larsson, Runblad has a lane, thought about it, Whitney now, rolled off his stick. Oh, that was the one. Now Whitney will play it to the right wing corner. Back out high, Runblad sends it across for Oliver Ekman-Larsson. Now back out high, Runblad takes a shot, and it kind of hit a skater, somebody's stick in front. Now Runblad, another shot, it's loose, and it's covered up by Steve Mason, and he holds.
Well, I think this has been the missing link. It's Runblad. The way he moves across that line, the way he supports the puck. Both shots on this power play have come off the stick of number two, Runblad. See how he follows that puck. He comes over for support. You got to help out on the power play. You got to move over. You got to read and react. It's those offensive instincts that you're starting to see as this number two, Runblad, gets more comfortable.
Coyotes win the draw. Ekman-Larsson looking around. Over to Whitney. Whitney now on the left wing side. Works it to the front. They jam away at it. The Captain Doan can't put it home. And the Jackets will clear all the way back.
Well, again, it's Mason. And he's got that paddle right on the out ice. Shane Doan can't get it up. He tries to find a little crack in the armor, but there was nothing.
Already four Coyotes shots on the power play. They have to reset here, and Oliver Ekman-Larsson will bring it back. Whitney now, back to center dome. Gets it back to the Wizard, Ray Whitney, bounced over his stick to lay it offside, and this one will be cleared. So the Coyotes with under a half a minute to go in their power play. Ekman-Larsson to center, back through the neutral zone. Whitney will deflect it into the corner. Vermette for Ekman-Larsson, and now Vermette to set it up. Across for Runblad, but that one comes out of the zone, and this is pretty much going to do it here for the Coyotes' man advantage.
Yeah, one bad pass, and it kills everything.
Down low, and now taking it away is Jack Johnson, and he'll clear it all the way up the ice. Quick counter here, Doan. over the line. Took a bump from Fetter Tooten. And out of the zone for Rick Nash, and here he comes, back through center. Sends one to the glove of Smith. And in behind the net, Gamble gave it up, and a shot and a goal! So a turnover, and the Jackets have taken a 4-2 lead.
Well, they're still celebrating. Tell me this isn't big to the Columbus Blue Jackets. And here's the play, an innocent shot. Mike Smith typically plays that puck. He gives it to Keith Yandle for the safer play. And Yandle just bobbles it. Second effort there by Rick Nash. And that is a big goal for the Jackets. And this one stings. That's a second effort play for Rick Nash, who's got 3 points in this hockey game.
So Nash with 2 goals and an assist. The Jackets with a 4-2 lead. One behind the net, bouncing puck in front goes over the top, and we get a whistle. And we'll get a faceoff. Four-two Columbus with a pair of goals here in the third period of play. Let's give you the results from tonight's Taco Bell Tex Bowl. Coyotes MVP on the blue line. 47% of you believe it's been Adrian Acoin. It's had a rough couple of games defensively for not only the defenseman but the entire Coyotes team. But Adrian Acoin, when you look at the whole body of work, he's been terrific as this one has played out.
Yes, he has. He's been very steady on that back end.
Behind the net, Summers. And now Gordon will flip it out.
Coyotes are going to have to do some fast work here.
Well, they need to get it back to a one-goal game, get a quick one here, and then maybe they get Smith to the bench in the latter stage of the period. Taylor Pyatt. And it's cleared out of there. That's becoming quite the road trip for the Columbus Blue Jackets. Shutout winners on Thursday night in Denver. And on their way here tonight with a 4-2 lead, but a lot of time remaining in 5:08. Here to go in the third period.
And you have to give Mason a ton of credit. Early in this game, when the Coyotes really came with a real big push, a time there in the second as well, and then this third period, he has been rock solid between the pipes.
And behind the net, Michael Roosevelt. Orpikoski flips this one deep. Wisniewski goes after it. Boy, he went awkward there. I hope he's okay.
Well, he's still down. He's getting up very gingerly. He's holding his right wrist.
Well, Wisniewski heads to the bench. He's talking to the one official here. Gillies. Turnover, Dorsett over the line, but this one is offside. Now we get some pushing into the corner. Wisniewski is holding the wrist, I believe, or the hand. Here's what happened.
Goes in really awkward. Here's how the scrum starts. Dorsett always stirring the pot. Roosevelt in there. Shane Doan comes over to settle things down, make sure nobody takes an unnecessary penalty, as Wisniewski still looking at that right hand.
Is he looking at his thumb maybe? Looks like he may be headed to the bench or to the dressing room.
Yeah, he's.
Well, don't forget Monday you can join Fox Sports Arizona at the Scottsdale Ice Den for the Coors Light Cold Hard viewing party. It starts at 5. Coyotes are going to be in Pittsburgh to take on the Penguins. You can get there early to secure your seat. We'll have great food and drink specials as well. It's the Coors Light Cold Hard viewing party Monday at 5. So get off work, head right over to the Ice Den and watch the Coyotes. They take on Evgeny Malkin and the Pittsburgh Penguins. And the Penguins are on a roll. That's going to be another challenge for the Coyotes. Penguins entering tonight's game in Denver. They've won 4 straight. Whitney across. holding is Rundblad to Whitney in front, and he fanned on it.
How about that play there by Rundblad? Outstanding vision.
They play it in behind the net, Rundblad. Through center, Torres got it in over the line, intended that time for Doan. And the Jackets come right back. Yandle takes it away, Doan has it. Over the line, glove save that time, Steve Mason. Oh, he's been red hot with the glove here tonight, Tyson.
Has he ever? And again, you gotta mention, he catches with that right hand. Something that you don't see very often. Typically the goaltender is a left-handed glove. And the Coyotes ripping that puck to that blocker side. That would be the blocker side, but it's his glove. He's been outstanding, sucking everything up all night. 29 saves in this hockey game. Good early, good in the middle frame, and then here late in this hockey game, giving the Coyotes nothing.
It reminds me a little of Jose Theodore. Probably just because he's left-handed. Torres now bring it back and over the line. Doan chasing it down. Jack Johnson will take it away. Intercepting Doan now, right to the net. Try to set it up there for Torres. Under three to go. Coyotes need a pair, and they need them in a hurry. Doan. Torres. Picked. Nash will get it out. Had a whale of a game here tonight for the Columbus Blue Jackets. And for a guy that supposedly wanted to be traded, as Roosevelt brings it in over the line, I mean, he's showing me a lot. He hasn't quit on his team at all.
Well, not at all, and you can't blame the guy. I mean, you get rid of Carter, and talking about rebuild again, not a chance does he want to be a part of that. He's been a part of it for way too long. He wants to win. You can't blame him. I was just a little surprised the way it came out in the papers.
Hansel's going to try to get it out. That's the thing, the Blue Jackets, they're near the cap in terms of spending. They've done that. They've made the commitment on the salary side, as this one is going to be played back at center and now dumped right back in. But I think what really got their season off kilter was the Wisniewski suspension. Missing the first eight games, and that kind of messed up their whole rotation on the blue line.
There's the puck. Smith.
Yeah, he's gone to the bench for the extra attacker. Bouncing puck in front. Oh, big hit that time. Dorsett got lit up by Korpikoski. And now Rundblad will set it up. Keith Yandle will bring it out. These two teams will play Tuesday night in Columbus. At Nationwide Arena, Rundblad into the corner. Coyotes trying to work it to the front. Now Rundblad, right point. Minute nine remaining. Great if the Coyotes could get one here and make it real interesting, but it's going to be knocked away. Gillies out of the zone, and that's it. This one will be in the books as a win for the Columbus Blue Jackets.
Well, this one's going to sting a little bit. That's Gillies' second goal of the season. He's been real good in this hockey game, and Rundblad just couldn't keep this puck alive on the blue line. This plays it there. No support. Gillies fires it in the open cage. This is now the second time the Coyotes have fallen to the Jackets. Two straight games. 4-3 in that first one in Columbus, and 5-2 is the score here tonight. The Coyotes on that big streak, the huge February, and now dropped two in a row.
So Ekman Larson will bring it out. Coyotes will look for some help a little bit later on tonight in San Jose in a form of a Blues win against the San Jose Sharks. And back of the line, it'll be cleared back to center ice. Well, this one disappointing.
Again, you fight back in these hockey games, but you dig yourself a hole, a two-goal deficit here tonight again, and it makes it tough.
Gordon works it towards the front. Played around. In behind the net, 2 seconds to go. And the Columbus Blue Jackets tonight get victory number 20. As they improve to 20-38-7. And the Coyotes falling to 33-23-9 in a 5-2 loss.
Well, the Coyotes better clean some things up in their game. It's been the starts. They got a chance to put something together, hit the reset button again in Pittsburgh. They need to think long and hard about this one here tonight.
So the Blue Jackets win it. Tyson and I will give you our thoughts on the game in just a moment. But right now, let's get you to Coyotes Club South and Jody Jackson. It's Coyotes Live, presented by CenturyLink, and it starts right now.